The number of sickle cell patients on the 64 habited islands is increasing rapidly due to the authentic testing.
So for us, we are currently having 86 patients today as 2023, but we started with only two patients, that is in March 2015. Now, you realize between that time and now, the number has increased.
Although the drugs in health centers are not enough, the patients are enrolled in treatment and care. The government policy, which excludes health center foes from getting hydroxyurea, has been another setback in sickle cell treatment until 1 year back, where Kalangala Health Center foe was considered. The use of these drugs has posed a significant drop in sickle cell patients' admissions from 90% to 20%.
The problem with those drugs is, one, we have stockouts. Secondly, some drugs are not given us at Health Center 4. For them, they are given to hospitals, to regional referral hospitals, national referral hospitals, forgetting that a place like Kalangala Health Center 4 is a point of referral for the whole of the island.
The burden of identifying sickle cell patients in the past years has been leaving parents spending over millions of shillings in private hospitals. Gertrude Namwaya, a mother to twins of 12 years, narrates that she used to carry them for blood transfusion in Masaka before knowing that her twins had sickle cell.
Nabazalanga balunzi ngira beyagaza ne bagenda batandika okulwala.
They were born healthier, but within a short period of time, my twins started falling sick promptly. I used to take them to Masaka for blood checkups, but health workers never discovered the disease despite the constant attacks. It was too costly for me. I used to spend between 900,000 to 1 million shillings. The Ministry of Health, under its National Sickle Cell Program, has embarked on screening newborn babies in order to identify patients at an early stage.
For example, we have enrolled newborn screening in about 150 facilities all over the country, okay? And actually, the good news with that is that we are still lobbying for more to make sure that more facilities do newborn screening.
With partnership between Kalangala Health Center 4 and Duke University of United States of America, there is hope that the burden of sickle cell will decrease using different measures of research inclusiveness.
Our main mission is to reduce the burden of sickle cell disease in Kalangala, Uganda.
Being a genetic disease, there is a call out to the government for more efforts in availing necessary drugs for treatment.
So the policy should change that all our first drugs of choice should be available to us.
Report compiled by Samuel Nkuba for the news.